Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel, and I'm back at it again with a brand new YouTube video. So as you can see by the title, you know exactly what's up. So it has been a very long week, work up and down, everything, and you know, I'm just doing my little reset, cleaning, all of that, just so that I can go into the new week feeling fresh and just put together. So I'm just here changing my bedspread, and I do this every single week. It doesn't matter if I only sleep on my bed after I shower, it really doesn't matter. Every single week I change my bedding, right? For 2 weeks, but guys, I was extremely busy. I had so much on my hands. I had appraisal, I had a lot of ups and downs. It was just a very busy 2 weeks. So now I am back. I am trying to be consistent. My goal this year is to be consistent with YouTube. As you know, we're on the road to 1K. But yes, it's better to be back than not to be back at all. So even though I missed out 2 weeks and I promised myself to post every week, you know, at least I am back. And I did not fall into the fear of, oh, it doesn't make sense I go back because I was, you know, out for 4 weeks and, you know, I just, whatever the case may be, guys, I'm back. And even though it was not every week, but I'm still consistent, I'm still putting out the effort, I'm still getting it done, right? So I'm just here washing my dishes. As you know, weekend reset, I cleaned up my room, I washed, and I also cleaned my bathroom and all of that. So yeah, so basically guys, when life hits you down, don't stay on the ground. Get up and get it done. Alright? Sometimes you see other people and you wonder how they do this, how they do that. But at the end of the day, those persons, they don't allow what happens in life to let them stop. So not because you had 2 bad weeks does not mean that you must give up on the year and say nothing is working out for me and I should just stop this. No, you should push on. Fight the fight and get it done. So right here, I'm gonna give my little Coco a bath, and guys, Coco doesn't love to bathe. bathing, and recently I found out that I should bathe her in warm water, and it was a better experience. She wasn't fighting me. She wasn't fighting me when I was bathing her in the warm water, but this water was cold as it was from the pipe. But you know, as we go along, we learn. So I learned that I should bathe her in warm water, but she hates bathing and she's always running out of the pan. I always have to hold her down. I know it looks like I was dipping her, like I was forcing her and everything, but you know, that's just Coco. She's just stubborn and all of that attitude and all those things. So yeah, anyways, yeah, I'm bathing Coco and I'm gonna dry her off because she was really trembling here, but she gotta stay clean, guys, okay?
I'm just unpacking my groceries. As you can see, I'm extremely tired. So these are just granola. I love having these with my yogurt or just a snack. And I have popcorn. I really love these. These are my favorite snacks. Red Hot. Peanuts. I like to eat peanuts with my yogurt. Freshers. These are for my pasta. I really love pasta. Well, I've been serving a little pasta from the other day, so I'm always having pasta as a side. Not every day, because I'm sure it's not healthy to have every day, but like on days when you cook like a larger meal, I like having pasta. Mac and cheese for those work days when you just want to whip up something quickly. This is it. Just cheese tricks. You might be wondering why I have so many snacks. Sometimes, like when I'm packing my lunch kit for work, I would just add a snack or two to have in between before lunch, because sometimes I leave out and honestly not all the time I get to make breakfast, so sometimes these snacks help to save a life. And just sometimes at work you just need something to munch on. Coffee to take with me in the morning. Rock up. Just regular sweet biscuits. And just a small slice of cheese. And bread. This is not a week for light shopping. This is just one of those weeks when you are just filling the gaps. So like things that are missing or that you would need, you just do a quick run and pick these things up from the supermarket. Now I started to buy them in the smaller container, because when I buy them in the big container, I often eat up everything at once, and I'm really trying to portion how I eat snacks. So like these smaller containers help me to eat less, because these are filled with calories. Ooh. Orange juice, just a filler for the week, and I'm gonna buy apple juice, pork, a few to take pork for lunch one of these days, and yogurt, just adding back to the stock, and grapes. I really love grapes. Also, I picked up some ground provisions, but I already packed those into the fridge. So like tomato, onion, string bean, pak choi. What else? Carrots, because I'm going to make carrot juice. And the next thing that I got are, I bought new containers for work, because I was just using a regular container. So I bought these, which seem like they have a better seal, so that nothing won't leak in my lunch kit or anything. I don't normally have leaking issues with the dish I had before, but this is just more, it's just giving. And I also bought a coffee cup. I am really moving, like I'm tired. I bought a coffee cup because in the mornings I have to leave for work early, and sometimes I don't get to drink anything warm. Probably I could just make it and put it in the cup and bring it to work and drink it. So because of that, I'm normally having issues where guests are taking me up. So I bought a cup so that I can bring warm stuff to work and not just chug cold stuff in the morning. And you know, so yes, I can bring tea in this. If I make my oats porridge, yes, it will keep it warm. Right, that's it for the grocery haul. So as I said, this is just a top up, guys, and it's just an in-between shopping, things that I ran out of and I would have needed for the coming week. So
in my weekly resets, I always include prayer, I always include God. He is so important, and I always just ensure to cover the week for my family, myself, my husband, my friends, just everybody that comes in my life, you know. So that's a very important part of my weekend reset.
He shall appear in glory. He will regard the prayer of the destitute and not despise their prayer. Could you tell a neighbor, he's bringing about me? Ready to say that he's reading about me. When he built up Zion, he shall appear in glory. He will regard the fire of the destitute, that's me, and not despise their prayer. This shall be written for the generation to come.
Right here, I'm just seasoning. I was seasoning the curry chicken right here. Yeah, I was seasoning the curry chicken. I just want you guys to know that, you know, God is really good. He is really, really good. And, you know, He has just always been there for me. And right here, I'm just packaging the pork. I seasoned it beforehand because I wanted to cook it during the week, so you know, adult girl, yeah.
We have the victory in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, devil is what I do.
Normally go to church on Sundays, but for the past 2 weeks, 3 weeks, I've been so busy. So, you know, I was actually watching my church service online because they go live on Sundays. So, you know, it helps me to just still feel a part and just still feel like I'm in the presence of God. I mean, we're always in the presence of God, but you know, yeah, you get what I'm saying, right? Okay, thank you. Guys, I have definitely found a new obsession. I've definitely found a new obsession, and guess what it is? It's carrot juice. I have really, really, guys, I'm in my juicing era. I'm juicing everything. I just feel like it's more healthy, less sugar, and I don't know. I think it helps with my skin. Yeah, I'm in my juicing era. So, like, every Sunday, I've started to make juice. Yep. Every Sunday, I've started to make juice because your girl is now an adult and health comes first. My friends are gonna laugh at that part, but whatever. So, yes, guys, I'm in my juicing era. So, if we're friends, you're always, it's all our family. You know, I would really appreciate, like, you know, if you want to give me some June plums, some mangoes, you know, whatever you want to give me. But yeah, I'm in my juicing era. Yeah, I'm in my healthy girl era, right? Well, not completely healthy girl era, but yeah, I'm trying. Yeah, so give me my props, right? So yeah, I'm just grating nutmeg into the carrot juice. You know, to give it some flavor along with the cinnamon. Oh my god. And I'm also gonna add some vanilla. And guys, you should try this. You should try this. I promise it's refreshing and you feel a boost of energy. So this is my dinner for the day, for Sunday. And if you have reached thus far in my video, don't be bad, man. Don't be a loser. Allow me to strive. So I just want you to hit the like button, drop a comment, and share my video. You know, it's just a little simple thing that you can do for me. I'm not asking you for money. So yes, subscribe, like, comment, and share. Thank you so much. I really appreciate y'all. Alright, so here I'm just ironing for the new work week. I normally iron every week. 5 suits of clothes. You know, I don't come home each evening and iron. I iron every week because I won't have the strength in the evenings. I can promise anybody that. Right? So this is just my little vloggy vlog. And my little reset, and as much as I was tired here, my feet were hurting and all, but I got stuff done, and I really love that for me. I really, really love that for me, right? Yeah. Here I'm just watching Ginny and Georgia and preparing some stuff for work. Now guys, don't ever think that I'm the most productive person in the world. I don't normally do this after work. When I come home and I leave work at work. Actually, I had appraisal the next day, so I was just preparing up some stuff, ensuring that everything is in order, writing my evaluations where necessary. You know, you don't catch me working at home, trust me. And I mean, when Ginny irritates, it couldn't be me alone. But yeah, guys, don't ever think that I am this overly productive, have it all together. Trust me, that's not me. But thank you guys so much for watching my video. I really hope that you enjoyed it, and I definitely won't keep you waiting long for the next video. All right, so love y'all. Bye.